James treats you so respectfully. You make a great couple.
Yeah, we do. So, Mom, I have some big news for you.
Really? Because I've got some big news for you, too.
Me first? I'm gonna have a baby.
But when?
6 months.
Whoops. Martha! I thought you never wanted to.
Not with Nikki. But then I met James, and he's just such a fantastic person. I wish there were more like him on this planet. Now there will be.
I'll be a grandmother. Finally. But how will I babysit with you so far away?
The babysitter like you, I'll import you to England.
Oh, Martha, you're making me so happy. But don't tell your father the baby is due yet. By the time you have it, he won't remember that you started before wedlock. Since his last stroke, he doesn't add so good. Well, now I have something to tell you.
Okay. I'm all ears.
Well, I'm driving again.
I know what a giant step that was for you, Mom. Congratulations.
And I am going to be singing a solo with my chorus at Wilton Hall, Mother's Day, May 17th.
Ma? All right, let me think. Oh, we don't go back to the UK until the 18th. I can come. Oh, great.
And I'm leaving your father.
Huh?
I've got a good attorney, a secret place to stay. Timing is just right.
Mom.
I borrowed a couple suitcases and I put them in my car trunk. I've been putting stuff out there for weeks, leaving dummy clothes in the closets. Now that I showed James your baby pictures, I can put them out there too.
You planned this all out.
I'll keep you out of it, Martha. I don't want to involve you at all, but I'll be going underground for a while. So he might need you in the beginning.
When?
He's going in for gallbladder removal on Monday. I'm going to explain everything in a letter and leave it with the nurse to give to him after the surgery. That way, if he has a heart attack, he's already in the hospital.
Wow.
I've dreamed of leaving, but it was always just make-believe. I remember when you were a little girl and you ran away from home and I went with you? Then we came back because you missed your teachers so much. I didn't want to come back. But we had no money, no place to go.
I remember. Well, it's about time.
You're not mad?
No, I don't know how you put up with this opera between you two for so long.
People got married for life in our day. And he supported us, and he drove us around, and he put up with me.
He put up with you?
Oh, Martha. If only you hadn't moved so far away.
London was as far as I could get without having to learn another language.
I feel like you and Al fighting all the time was mostly my fault.
Hey, his chauvinism made me a woman's liver by the time I was 12.
A woman's liver?
All his yelling. He made me want to fight for my independence. And now you're going to get some, too. You are becoming the mother I always wanted.